Well, Josh, this is a high-stakes race. Whoever wins, we're probably not going to see them in another debate until 2016. That being said, tonight was a good chance to get to know these two candidates.
Senate hopefuls Kelly Ayotte and Paul Hodes clashed early in this debate over how to kickstart the economy.
And the last thing we should be doing right now is raising taxes, but yet that's what Congressman Hodes wants to do.
How in the world are tax cuts for multimillionaires and billionaires that drive our deficit $700 billion deeper in the hole going to help our economy? How is that going to help our deficit?
Congressman Hodes, I understand why you want more money to be spent in Washington, because your record of spending is one, since you have served in Congress, the deficit has increased over 500%.
My opponent wants to go back to exactly the same policies that dug us into the hole we're trying to get out of.
When asked about how they'd be an independent voice in Washington, both were quick to burnish party-bucking credentials.
On the issue of earmarks, unfortunately, Republicans have asked for earmarks as well as Democrats, and I certainly will stand up to my party on that issue.
I opposed the Wall Street bailout because I didn't think it was good for middle-class families and working folks.
On health care, Hodes defended his vote in favor of reform, referencing Keene resident Gail O'Brien, a cancer patient denied insurance until now.
She's the first person in the United States to be able to take advantage of the pool that allows people with pre-existing conditions to get health insurance.
Ayotte favors repeal.
Certainly, when it comes to Mrs. O'Brien and others, we want to make sure that people have coverage in this country. But we don't need that from Washington. There can be state solutions.
On foreign policy, differences over Afghanistan.
We cannot have an endless commitment to a third century country with a corrupt government.
Well, I can tell you one thing that we shouldn't have done, and that is to signal to our enemies exactly when we're going to leave.
All right, so strong performances, but here's the real question. With just 4 days left, does it make a difference in the wider race? For more on that, let's go back inside to Josh and James. Josh?